The concept of a percent is among the most widely used mathematical construction found in real-life applications. For example, percents appear as a sales tax when you make purchases and as tips when you eat at a restaurant. They also appear as interest when taking out a car loan or when using a credit card. You see them when reading and interpreting scientific information and materials. They're important to medicine and budgets. You will also see them when working with probability and statistics. The word percent means for each 100. It establishes a proportion relative to 100 objects. For example, an 8% sales tax means that you will pay $8 for each $100 of goods you purchase. This means that if you spend $200, you will pay $16 in taxes, and if you spend $1,000, you will pay $80 in taxes. This works out easily when working with multiples of $100, but what happens if you need to compute the sales tax for a purchase of $632.74? To handle this situation, we need to establish a general relationship for percents. The primary formula we use for percents is percentage equals part over whole times 100%. To use this formula, we need to make sure we understand what each word represents. The percentage is the number that represents the proportion for each 100 objects. The whole is the reference quantity, and the percentage is being measured relative to this amount. The part represents the quantity that is in proportion to the whole. The multiplication by 100% is a conversion factor for converting a number into a percent. For example, suppose you tipped $5 on a $25 meal. In order to determine the tip percentage, you need to identify the variables in the formula. The $25 price tag for the meal is the quantity we're measuring the tip size against, so that is the whole. The tip is the quantity you're measuring relative to the cost of the meal, and that is your part. And the percentage is the number you're trying to determine. When working with this equation, you will need to know two out of the three quantities. From here, you can use algebra to solve for the third variable. Here are two other sample problems. The marketing budget for a company is $85,000. This quantity represents 5% of their total budget. How large is the company's total budget? You make a $632.74 purchase, and the sales tax rate is 8%. How much will you pay in sales tax? The key to solving these problems is to understand which numbers represent which values. What is the reference quantity? What is being measured against that quantity? What number is the percent? Once you understand this, it's just a matter of plugging the values into the equation and solving for the unknown. In class, we will look at a few more examples of this, including the idea of percent change.